He's here doing a tour in Djibouti Africa for fighting for freedom, fighters for freedom. So you are 15-1, correct?
Yep, 15-1.
So what was your first UFC fight?
It was crazy. I fought in Atlantic City against Mirab Balashvili, and ended up getting fight of the night that night. So it was a good first fight in the UFC, I guess. It was wild, back and forth fight, and getting the sub at the end.
Alright, your first loss, what was that like, coming out of that?
That was tough. I went 11-0 as an amateur, and then I made it to 7-0 as a pro. I fought for the Titan FC world title, and I lost to a very tough Brazilian fighter. I was young. I was 22 or 23, and taught me how to lose, and I got back in the gym, worked hard, and I've won that 8-fight win streak since then.
So everybody has a cheat meal, right? What's your favorite cheat meal?
Oh man, back home they have a place called a Killer Burger. They have this peanut butter pickle burger. Oh man, it's fire.
Cool.
Oh, it is good. Think about it right now. Yeah.
So, a lot of people wonder what it takes to get into an octagon and just go balls to the wall and fight somebody that you've never met before. It's like, hey, you're fighting this guy. How do you channel that energy?
Because
it's against human instinct
to
fight some random person.
Yeah, no, definitely. You definitely have to be a little crazy. That's definitely a big part of it. But I love to compete, so that's all it is to me. And I don't have to hate my opponent. I don't have to go in there and want to kill him or anything. I just know this is what I do. It's a sport. It's a legit sport, So that is fun for me, and that's what I love to do. So it makes it easy.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you do for a workout? To get yourself fit to fight for the next fight that's coming up?
Well, there's a lot that goes into it. Especially nowadays, you have to be well-rounded, and you have to be smart with the way you train, so you can't just go and kill yourself. I came up from a wrestling background, so we just grind ourselves into the ground, that's not the way you're supposed to do it anymore. You're supposed to get the right recovery time, right amount of time in between practices. So,
yes.
So I'm working with a great strength conditioning coach, Justin Moore, at Champ Camp, and so he's in charge of getting me fight ready. He gets me with a heart rate monitor, we monitor throughout camp, we monitor my recovery time within a minute, and so that's the biggest part of getting in shape, and then obviously the sparring rounds, going to the grappling rounds, the private lessons, hitting hits and stuff, the game planning. So there's a lot that goes into it.
Alright. Who is your idol in the UFC before you join?
I had a few, Randy Couture was a big one. He's from kind of my area.
Okay.
So I met him when I was, 10 years old. So he was someone I always looked up to. And then also Diego Sanchez, he's a Mexican fighter as well. He's just crazy. You watch him play out there. He likes to brawl. But, he gets into it. And I feel like I have a little bit of that, warrior spirit, too.
So, when you first got a call saying that, hey, we want you to play for UFC, what was that like?
Man, it was crazy. Actually, was the LFA world champ. I beat, to win the title, I beat Chico Caymans, who fought in the UFC 8 times.
Okay.
Then I still didn't get signed. I defended the belt with a 59-second knockout, and while I was still in the cage from celebrating from that title defense, my manager was right there, and the UFC had texted him saying that I've been fighting 4 weeks in Atlantic City. So I had just defended my belt, and then I basically got the call on the spot. So I was ready to hang it up just because it was so much work, and there wasn't a lot of money at the time.
Yeah.
So it was tough. It was definitely tough living. So I was kind of going through that fight saying this might be my last one, but I'm gonna sign, and it just kind of worked out perfectly.
That's good. So there's a lot of up and downs in sports. What was your highest moment where you besides like getting signed to UFC, that you were like, this is amazing?
That last fight for me, I was I fought the number 15 ranked guy in the world in Australia and sold out crowd at the Rod Laver Arena. And man, we put on a great fight. Bloody, I was cut above my eyes. He was cut, a big cut. It was insane. And then, you know, I got the win. I jumped on the cage and I was like screaming. I see the sold out crowd, man. They're all going
crazy.
They're getting goosebumps thinking about it. Because I fought some crazy play. I fought malls. I fought a bar. They put a cage in the bar. So, you know, I fought some crappy places. So, to be where I'm at and to, you know, in the places I fought, you know, it was awesome.
Okay, and with the ups comes the downs. So it was like the lowest of the low moment.
Definitely my loss. You know, I have that one loss on my record, and that was tough. And not only because I lost, but because I couldn't get a fight for a year afterwards. I had, I think, 8 or 9 people fall out. So I was sitting you know, on the sidelines for a year just thinking about the loss, because you're only as good as your last fight. So my last fight was a loss, and I just couldn't get that out of my mind because I couldn't get back in there. So finally I got the chance to get back in there, and I just told myself to stay as active as I can.
Is it hard, like, staying focused in the octagon, like, at first? Like, big crowd, not really used to it?
It's something you definitely have to be used to. You know, a lot of people, they call it first-time octagon jitters, where you basically have an adrenaline dump walking out to the cage. You see the bit in the line, you see the big crowd, and then you get all pumped up, and by the time you get in there, you just kind of, like, exhausted. So you gotta kind of just focus and just know that you gotta channel that energy for once the fight starts.
Okay. Who's the, like, well, in the UFC right now, who's the most famous star?
I've met a ton of them, but I mean, I guess the most famous would be John Jones.
John Jones.
I trained over at Santa Cowboys around this place for a little bit.
Okay.
And I mean, he might be able to. But, yeah, I got to meet John Jones in Albuquerque.
All right. Have you trained with a lot of big names?
Here, not too much. Not too much. I spent some time with Team Alpha Male when I was a little bit younger, seeing if I was going to make a move. So I met, like, Uriah Faber, T.J. Dillashaw, Chad Mendez, all those guys. And then, you know, I trained with Chael Sonnen, and Adrian Zane, so, I mean, those are big names right there.
Yeah.
I stayed at Cowboys for John Dodson and all those guys.
So what age were you when you were just like, I want to be a fighter? That's what I want to be.
I don't know how I got into this. I always thought it was like, you know, a random thing, because my dad and my older brother would always watch it. They'd be watching Pride, they'd be watching UFC, and I actually hated it because I just wanted to hang out with them, and I was like, watch it. And I started wrestling from a young age, and then once I did wrestle in college, I had a buddy told me I might be good at it, so I tried it out. And kind of took off pretty quick.
What age did you start wrestling?
7.
7? That's nice.
Oh, that's awesome.
What was your favorite part about the sport that you did?
It's been a lot, just because we've traveled so many different countries in a short amount of time.
Yeah, 4 countries in like 2 weeks?
Yeah. But you know, the best part is, you know, getting to like grapple with you guys, you know, getting to get out there on the mats and just have that. You know, because I love grappling, I grew up wrestling, jiu-jitsu's awesome, so just that camaraderie you get when you get grappling, you know, you guys are all like super cool and appreciative, so it just makes the trip worth it for us.
Was there anybody that's like stuck out to you, like, just like, you know, what he's doing?
Oh, no, yeah, at just about every base we've been to, there's been, you know, at least one or two like high-level like grapplers, so yeah, but this group has definitely been like, you guys have like a consistent program, and you guys all seem pretty legit.
So in your training, when it comes to like all the different arts of fighting, what one do you like? I know you guys like focus on all of them, but what one do you feel like you lack in and you focus on more?
I think for a long time it was like my Muay Thai, my kicks, really, because I love wrestle, I love the box, I love the jiu-jitsu, but you know, like for a long time, I was just like a stiff wrestler, so
yeah.
It's hard to get those hips loose and throw those kicks. So that's what I've been working on for years, and that's why like where I'm definitely confident there. But I mean, if I said I need to work somewhere specifically, it'd be there. Yeah.
Okay. And what was the transition like going from wrestling to mixed martial arts. Because in wrestling, you're not supposed to be on your back.
Yeah.
Like, that's
yeah.
a dangerous place, but in mixed martial arts, you want to be on your back.
Honestly, it was natural. I have my older brother's only 17 months older than I am, so we grew up beating the crap out of each other. We'd be in our room and grapple for hours, go for submissions, but we didn't know what we were doing. I knew like one submission, he knew like one submission, and we would just fight forever to see who got that first, you know? So, you know, it just seemed kind of natural to switch over, honestly.
Okay. And one final question. Is the rumors true that UFC is as safe as WWE?
There's no way, man. I've been in 26 fights now, and I'll tell you, every time I've been in there, it's been great. That's never happened once, you know. It's never happened once to me. We're here to compete. We're here to test ourselves against the best in the world. So I'm not saying that couldn't happen. I think there has been a case of it that I think it was a fight in like Asia, where one of those fighters got offered it and he didn't take it. So he got in some trouble with his mom or something like that. So I know there was like, there has been like a story or two, but you know, from my experience, as far as I can say, like every fight, every point, every case has been real.
Alright, well thank you very much. I appreciate your time, man.
Of course, man.
And good luck with your journey.